Flashlight reviews are among the most boring pieces of crap on the internet. Unless, of course, people start reviewing flashlight reviews. So what makes them boring? The guy talking? All the testing. I was using it the other day and I don't have any footage of it, but you should just trust me. Or maybe because it's just about a flashlight. Also, a flashlight with 19 LEDs is going to be a pain in the ass to review. So goinggear.com sent me the Acebeam X80 for review. It's currently the brightest production flashlight out that takes up as much space as a beer can. Beer is something that helps make everything a little more tolerable. Hint, hint. In the box, you get this bright, flashy thing. A manual. A holster. A lanyard. Two spare O-rings. Four 3100 milliamp hour 18650 batteries. And some other documentation. The Acebeam X80 has a lot of LEDs. You have 12 regular white LEDs that create a little less than 25,000-ish lumens. Two red LEDs that work in conjunction with one another. Two blue LEDs. Two green LEDs. And a Nietzsche UV LED. So you can do your own crime scene investigations and look for those fluids. The rest of the light is made from airplane-grade aluminum. Takes, like I said earlier, 418-650 lithium-ion batteries. Has a glass lens, a standard tripod mount, and is a very floody light, meaning it scatters a ton of light in your immediate area and your peripherals, but doesn't throw very far into the distance. So let's take a look at those output levels. The section where most people, according to my analytics, begin to drop out. My figures and the Acebeams are on the screen. First, it's ultra low, which is near 100 lumens, so it's not really that low. You know, there was a time when a bright flashlight was a fraction of the ultra low mode here. Then is low. Then is mid. Then is high. Then is turbo. Then is turbo max. Also note the catch, 23,000 lumens at startup, 20,000 lumens, 280 at 30 seconds in. Those are the figures I measured. Then let's do the colored ones, the red. Only one mode of red. Then is green. Only one mode of green. Then be blue. Only one mode of blue. And then is UV. All the color modes other than UV are kind of bright and only feature one level. Like I said, you're like, sounds like a gimmick. Now the UI segment. I recently got a comment that this section is way too long. My analytics also prove that this is the part that the least amount of people watch. Go figure, because when it comes to a flashlight, if the user interface sucks, why buy it? So let's go over the basic operation and leave it at that. To operate the flashlight, press the button to turn it on. Cool. Press and hold to scroll through the main modes, starting with low, mid, high, red, green, blue, ultraviolet, and it loops over and over and over again until you release the button. The main operation loop has mode memory, so when you press the button to turn it off, it saves the last mode you used, except for the special modes. When you exit the special modes, it will come on in one of the regular modes. Hopefully that makes sense. Special modes are strobe, ultra low, turbo, and turbo max. The colored and the regular ones are all regular modes. To get to strobe, triple click from on or off. Cool. Ultra low, press and hold from off. Cool. To get to turbo from on or off, double click. Yeah. To get to turbo max, you need to be in turbo. Then double click again. Double-clicking when in turbo switches between the two. There's electronic lockout. You got to press and hold for over 2 seconds to lock it out electronically, and then press and hold for over 2 seconds to unlock it so you can operate it again. I would prefer you to unscrew the battery tube. This is not a light you want to turn on accidentally on one of the higher modes in your pocket or your bag, because it will melt stuff. Runtimes. All runtimes were achieved using the included batteries, and not other batteries or theoretical batteries. Make sure you put them in the battery carrier first, And as a note, the springs are thick in the carrier, so the batteries are a tight fit. The included batteries are about 68.7 millimeters long. Good luck trying to fit batteries much longer. People actually watched this part, which is weird. First is Turbo Max. It starts out at 23,000-ish lumens and ends up around 20,000 lumens 30 seconds in. So it's not a full 25,000. It's a pretty quick drop. So much heat and a tiny light. There's a big step down per the manufacturer after the minute in. It stabilizes at 2 minutes into about 4,045 lumens, if my math is correct, and it may not be. Then it has a few percent drop. Then at 1 hour, 30 minutes, light ceases to come out. Ending lumens were about 3,900. Not bad, it held the light just like the runtime said it would, basically. Acebeam sub 1.3 hours of total runtime. And by the way, this light is about 150 to 160 degrees-ish at a little over a minute in. Please wear gloves if you want to use the turbo mode. It'll be too hot to hold, I'm not joking. All lumens figures in the runtime tests and my estimations are my estimations and not the manufacturer's. Then it's turbo. 30 seconds in, I measure 10,322 lumens. It drops pretty fast. Again, these are estimates. Don't get mad if your light's figures are a little different. A little over 3 minutes in, it stabilizes at 3,922 lumens, runs for a little over an hour with just a percentage or two brightness drop, and then it ends its runtime at about 3,790 lumens. Please wear gloves on this mode too. Acebeam said a little over 1 hour and 30 minutes. That's kind of what this did, not bad. Then together we get high. At about 30 seconds in, I measure about 4,448 lumens. Right before 20 minutes in, we're at 4,180 lumens. Then there's that step down, 24 minutes in, and we're at 3,841 lumens. It runs steadily, not a whole lot longer than Turbo and Turbo Max. Ending brightness, technically, is 3,857 lumens, as far as my estimate goes. I guess that's not technical, is it? At about 1 hour and 34 minutes, it shuts off. Then be mid. At 30 seconds in, I measure 2,436 lumens. 5 minutes in, we drop to 2,415 lumens, or less than a 1% drop. 10 minutes in, we hit 2,394 lumens. Doot-doot-doot-doot. 20 minutes in, we're at 2,373 lumens. Feel free to double-check my math. I suck at math more than I do at YouTube. 1 hour in, we're at 2,342 lumens, or a little less than a 4% drop overall in initial brightness. Not bad. It holds its brightness until it shuts off at about 2 hours and 49 minutes. Acebeam says 3 hours. We're just under that. Close enough for me. I did not test the color modes out of respect for attention spans. Beam shots, my backyard. Here are the lights I'll be comparing them to in the rain. All lights seen here are among the brightest production lights available. I'll do a 1,000 lumen context light, and of course that one idiot will show up and say, "Those don't look bright." Cool, bro. It's a through-night neutron. I reviewed this a few months ago, and it looks like mine has less views than all those other people. Watch it. Get more views on it. It's a little over 1,000 lumens. Yes, verified lumens. By me. Now the X80. The catch to the X80 is that it is small and steps down, remember? The smaller and brighter lights tend to get the quicker they'll step down. That's just how it works. In order for any light to maintain 25,000 lumens for a reasonable amount of time, it'd have to be big or heavy, and have liquid or fan cooling, sometimes called active cooling, and use more than 4 batteries. Compactness is not friendly to high lumens. I don't care what anyone says. I don't know who would say that, but that's not for me. Now the Acebeam X45, it used to be the brightest production light. I reviewed that. The Acebeam X45 is not as floody as the X80 because the X45 uses bigger reflectors. The X80 is a scatterer of light, more so than any other lights here. Leave it up for a few seconds more. Bloop, doop, doop, doo. Hey, where are you going, man? Now the Immolent DTF70. It has a cool white tint. It's a thrower, more so than the Acebeam. The Acebeam X45 and the X80 scatter more light. This focuses it a little bit more. By the way, I like the X45 the best out of all of the lights here. Well, maybe the second best. I like the Meteor. Doo-doo, now back to the X80. I think people start dropping off around midway in the beam shots. I've been looking at my analytics a lot lately. Doo-doo-doo. Now the Nikkor TM16 GT. This is much throwier than all the other lights here, because it has LEDs that throw better and a big-ass reflector system. Now, the Noctagon Meteor, still by far my biggest video ever, not of course my best, but my biggest, who knows why. 7200 lumens doesn't seem like a lot now, does it? Yeah, oh well. Back to the X80 for a second. I'm trying to keep this short. I'm trying to make this review shorter than some of my more recent ones. Now the Olight X7. I chose these lights because I feel like they're all lights people would consider alongside the X80 for a buying decision. But I also like to include throwier, less bright, and floodier lights in my beam shot section to give context. But I think you get that. All right, let's wrap it up. Here are the dimensions and the weight, and I'll keep talking. Really, 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 it is small. It's tiny. It's tinier than all the other lights with the exception of the Noctagon Meteor and, of course, the Thru-Night Neutron. The X80 is like a VIN light. If you don't know what a VIN light is, look it up, V-I-N-H. Except he'll make a brighter version of this. It steps down quick, is bright, can light up a whole backyard like daylight. The beam is not really throwy. The X45 can light up things further away. So get it if you need more throw. Olight has a brighter production light coming out with active cooling later this year, so maybe that one will have a larger battery pack and sustain brightness longer. Who knows? This light generates too much heat to sustain a brightness longer than a minute. 150 degrees a minute in is pretty freaking hot, so again, wear gloves, I can't stress that enough. The UV light edition is kind of cool, that would be like the one I would like, but I literally have no use for the other color modes, red, green, and blue. And remember, they're all over 100 lumens. Some people need dim colored modes, so keep that in mind. No visible PWM was observed on any modes during operation. Goinggear.com provided this light for review, and ending voltage after the battery tests was between 2.8 and 3 volts. If you like this review and are still watching, stay tuned for some of my other videos, linked at the end of this video so you can watch those reviews. Then like, subscribe, comment, click the bell so you can be notified when videos are released, usually on Mondays or Tuesdays, share the videos with your friends, drink a beer, follow me on Instagram. Thanks for watching.